Hey there. So it's my pre-workout chat that I love to do with you all. And I'm wearing my awesome new Versace sunglasses from Andrea. Thank you. I'm sitting here going, oh, that's kind of annoying, but whatever. So I'm the type of person, I just go live when I feel like going live. So if you want to catch my lives, you better just click follow. And then you'll get notified. Oh, sorry. You'll get notified when I go live, and you can always catch the replay. So I go live regularly on this page, which is my business page, and on my personal page. And I am Elise Leininger. I am a multimillionaire in network marketing, and I am so passionate about people living their lives authentically and stop making excuses for yourself. Stop apologizing for being emotional, taking up space, and being passionate. I'm really, really excited for you all to take a couple minutes today to reflect on 2018. And because here's what I've noticed is a lot of times about this time of the month in January, people start to beat themselves up because they feel like they're not sticking with their New Year's resolutions. They didn't succeed at doing what they set their minds to doing in 2018 or the previous year. And it's this cycle, right? How many of you guys can relate to that? Have you found yourself beating yourself up already? Because it's the new year and you haven't stuck with your New Year's resolutions, whether that is doing reach outs and follow ups and being consistently showing up in your business. Does that mean that you let things get in the way? Does that mean that you've been emotionally derailed? Does that mean that you don't want to do a post or a live video because you're afraid of what people will think about you? I don't know what it is for you, but we all have these little things in the back of our minds. And once you learn the tools to break free from the trap of these voices in the back of your head that keep you stuck, then the potential becomes limitless, okay? So please, please, please go ahead and drop a comment in below about how are you feeling right now? Because you got to feel to grow. In my opinion, you've got to feel to grow, you've got to feel to heal. And if you're struggling at all in your business, your personal life, a lot of times it's because you're in avoidance. And when we avoid things, we don't actually face them, and then they get worse and they continue to spiral. And so I want you all to take some time today to reflect over, what are you grateful for in 2018? What challenges did you face and learn from, grow from, overcome? Because the truth is, we all struggle with challenges. Nobody's immune to that, right? That's just part of living here, life on earth. So I want you to just take some time to first give yourself some grace. It's okay to get challenged. It's okay to doubt yourself. It's okay to, how do you even say it? Like the negative self-talk is a normal thing. And it's okay to take the time to heal that and overcome it. I don't know what's going on with my lighting here today. It's very bright. But yes, we had an incredible weekend in North Carolina where we mentored. We had 150 people, I think, in the room. And we were all there for the personal development, for the spiritual growth, for pouring into one another. And it was an incredible, incredible weekend. I feel like I'm looking a bit tired today because, oh my gosh, so much happened this weekend. And I just want to come on here today, though, and encourage you that every step is a step towards growth. And maybe you feel like you haven't accomplished the big thing, but if you're not taking the little steps every day, how will you accomplish the big thing, right? So share with us, what is it that you want to accomplish? Share with us in the comments below, what are you grateful for? What did you learn in 2018 about yourself, about your ability to show up? I mean, because you're still here. If you're watching this video, you're still here. You didn't give up. And so I want to give you a big shout out and really thank you for tuning in today. I want to thank you for stepping into your greatness. I want to thank you for being part of our community of heart-led leaders. And I also want to encourage you, just really encourage you, to take some time today to write about your previous year. Okay? Reflect. Because the number one thing that I have learned in growing a business as an entrepreneur, because let's be honest, being an entrepreneur is very, very different than being an employee. Okay. And you've got to set your own hours. You've got to review how you show up, review your efforts. So I think it's important to take some time. And I share this all the time. I'll choose a skill set or a mindset that I'm going to implement. I will laser focus on that for 30 days, learn about it, implement it every day. I'll get better and better and better. And then I will reflect back. So if you've struggled with analysis paralysis, perfectionism, or people pleasing, this will help you, because basically what it does is it gives you a skill set or a mindset to focus in on. Maybe it's sales, maybe it's connecting with others, maybe it's showing up for yourself and just journaling every single day. Whatever it is that you need to do, you need to do, just commit to it for 30 days. Then at the end of every month, so beginning of month, obviously, but at the end of every month, you stop and you reflect. So yes, we're mid-month January right now. So I want you to choose what is the skill set or mindset. Maybe the skill set or mindset for you is you're simply going to laser in on, how do I describe this? You're going to evaluate yourself on your previous efforts of last year, okay? Because what you focus on grows. And I want you to think through, who was I in my business? How did I show up? Who was I as a leader in my business? How did I show up? And then I want you to reflect forward, like in the coming 2 weeks, who is the person that is the heart-led leader in their business, right? Who do you need to become over the next 2 weeks to become more proactive, to become more reflective, to become more proactive rather than reactive? I want you all to consider that. And also, please drop a comment below if you're just joining us. If you're catching the replay, I want to see who that is and where you're joining from. I love interacting with you guys afterwards. So please don't be shy. Just go ahead, drop a comment, let me know. Click the share button if you found this helpful for your teams. But basically, I just want you to become more proactive and aware. Really, that's all the point of this video is. Be proactive, be aware, and take ownership of your business in terms of you set the sails of your ship, okay? The storms of life will happen, but you get to set the sail. Are you going to be reactive or proactive this year? You get to choose. So what is it? Drop a comment below and tell me, are you going to be reactive? Are you going to be proactive? Are you going to be self-empowered this year? How are you going to show up in your business? Who are you this year? You get to decide. This year, you get to decide who you are in your business in 2019. And it's definitely not too late to make that decision. So go ahead and share with us so we can encourage you. And thanks for tuning in. I can't wait to go live with you again. Talk soon. I'm headed into my workout. Bye-bye.